So in this segment, we'll talk about what a skew symmetric matrix is. So in a skew symmetric matrix, so you have a n by n matrix A, so it's a square matrix, is skew symmetric if Aij is equal to minus Aj Ji for all ij. So what we mean by here is just like the symmetric matrix, but it is a skew symmetric matrix, meaning that the negative element is here. So the ith row jth column is the negative value of the jth row ith column for all values of I comma j. So let's go and look at an example and see that what makes it a skew symmetric. There's an alternate definition also. If A, which is a n by n, which is a square matrix, is equal to minus of A transpose n by n matrix. So if the transpose of the matrix is negative of the original matrix, then A is skew symmetric. So this is an alternate definition, and some people like to use this definition because it involves the simply the transpose of the matrix as opposed to looking at each element, which is exactly the same thing. So let's look at an example here: 0, 2, 3, 0, 0, minus 6, minus 2, minus 3, plus 6. This particular matrix here, A, which is a 3 by 3, so it's a square matrix. That's the first requirement for a matrix to be skew symmetric. And then what we're saying is that Aij is same as minus Aji. So you're looking at the first row, second column is same as the second row, first column, but the only difference is the negative sign. And then I have first row, third column is same as the third row, first column, but the only difference is the negative sign. And then I have second row, third column here, which is minus 6, is same as the third row, second column, except for it is different by a negative sign. So that makes it skew symmetric, but we got to understand that here the diagonal is important to look at. All the diagonal elements which you see here, 0, 0, and 0, they have to be 0, because the only way you will find out that the diagonal element, this element, is going to be negative of itself is only possible if this element and this element is 0. So for every skew symmetric matrix, the diagonal elements will be always 0, because that's the only way to satisfy this condition. But for any of the non-diagonal elements, the only requirement is that it has the opposite sign. And that's the end of this segment.